Welcome at another video of Beer Brothers. And today we're going to do this in English. Why is this?
We do it in English because the beer you see here, we got it from Rogers and Lieke from Uganda.
Uganda?
Uganda.
Uganda.
In Dutch we say Uganda. Uganda.
Sounds the same. Sounds the same. Potato, potato.
That's why we do it in English, so Roger can understand us, and we think it's pretty cool to do at least one video ever in English.
Maybe there's a last one, or maybe our viewers are going sky high, who knows?
Yeah, and then we're gonna do it all in English from now on. But the story he tells is that this Guinness is brewed in Uganda, and it must be different than the ordinary. The other Guinness that you can buy here in the Netherlands.
Well, the bottle says it's brewed in Uganda, so do you think that is true? Yeah, I guess true.
Yeah, sure, true.
Anyways, this one, not so long ago, I did a video about this one, so well, you can look it up. But of course, this is all about tasting the difference between a Guinness 4 Extra and a Guinness Draft brewed in Ireland. I think there must be a difference, because this is like 4.2% ABV, and that's what, 6.5 ABV, so good.
And I think that one is a nitro, and this one will be on oxygen, I guess,
the CO2.
CO2, so there must be some different in taste.
Definitely, because I think, well, I mean, that 2% will do something. You know what, let's just pour it first and then see how this goes. So I'm gonna split this in two glasses, and usually, as I showed you in the other video, you pour this in one pint, of course. So I'm not sure how this goes. I have two cooler glasses here.
We're just gonna try it. So before we go any further, Lieke and Roger, thank you very much.
Thank you very much for this one.
Yeah, because the story is that Roger did do a really big walk to arrange it on time to get us to the Netherlands to me. So
so there's a lot of effort in that beer to bring it here.
Oh yeah.
Great. I mean, that's when people do something for beer, that's always great. I think, did he have beer for himself then as well? I mean, when you have a long hike, then any beers.
Yeah, well, maybe Roger, you can say it in the comments.
Yeah.
Did you have a beer after the long walk?
You should have.
Okay.
I think we should start with this one, because this is normally, of course, you start with a lighter one when you do a beer tasting. So this is creeping up a bit. As you can see, this is the nitro version, and a nitro nitrogen that makes this fluffy, beautiful, beautiful, yeah, cream colored head. And as nitrogen, it has smaller bubbles compared to
you can see it, like this is the bubbles with the nitro, and this is the bubbles with the CO2.
Can you see that?
I know, on the video, yeah, a little bit.
Well, you can see that, well, put the other one. Just the structure of the foam. This one has really fine, small bubbles, and that one has more bigger, foamy bubbles.
Yeah. Well, and to look at the color, is it the same color, or?
Well, from here it does, but
yeah,
I don't know.
I think it's the same color.
It's, yeah,
but the color is,
the color of the foam is different though.
Oh yeah,
I mean, this is more browner, the export version. I love the Guinness, by the way, so dig in.
Yeah.
Cheers, bro.
Cheers.
You know what? When I think of Guinness, it's crushable. It's dark, it's black, and you think, oh, this is a heavy beer, but it's not. It's super crushable.
And you can drink it easily, and it's not the with some stouts you got the hard taste of coffee, and this is smooth.
It's subtle. The of course there's roasted, not just roasted body there, so you taste the roasted body, but it's
it's soft, it's smooth,
it's refreshing. That's the thing about this beer. And it makes it more drinkable because of the smaller nitrogen bubbles.
Mm-hmm.
That makes a difference as well.
Yeah, I really like it.
Ooh.
I don't drink it too much, but
very often, but
no, well,
I have to drink it more every time. Yeah. When I have one, and I think, oh man, I love this. I love the drinkability. I love the flavor. I love everything about this beer. But how do I drink it ever?
But right. When you want to know more about this beer, you can look it on the other video with Nathan. And well, maybe for the English people, you don't understand.
Learn Dutch or something, whatever. It's now all about this one. I'm really curious about it. I think it's really cool. So,
cheers again. And Roger, cheers. With the smell, it's...
The
smell is... pretty much the same.
Kind of similar because the roasted barley, but it's more a little bit more red fruits maybe, but also more dried fruit.
Yeah,
the fourth one, and just the aroma is a little bit thicker.
Yeah,
it's a little bit more. It's a little bit more.
But a little bit more and a little bit thicker can.
Licorice maybe.
Yeah, but that's it. Maybe the difference with the alcohol, 6.5 or.
In the end, it's a more thicker version. It's an export version, so usually it was higher in alcohol, just to keep it well during the travels. Cheers, there we go.
The taste is different.
Where you get this blindly, would you say it's both a Guinness?
No.
No, I mean, that's right. That's the whole thing about this one. It's Guinness because the roasted barley, that's such the remarkable thing about Guinness is the roasted barley, and that's definitely in there.
But when you got this, it's the smoothness, the refreshing thing, and this is less smooth, less refreshing, so
more flavorful.
Yeah, much more flavor and
more liquor. It reminds me of licorice, or how do you call it? Soothout.
Yeah, licorice.
That's licorice.
Licorice. And but I like this one too.
Yeah, it's almost incomparable because this the mouthfeel is totally different because of the CO2, of course. So with this one, you feel the bubbles. That's the carbon dioxide, of course. That's like beer, but beer does. The special thing about the Guinness draft that's it's hardly has any bubbles. It's really really tiny bubbles. That's it,
and that makes a huge difference. A huge difference.
That's the thing. I think that's a cool thing about this comparison, that you now experience that mouthfeel is a really big part of how you experience beer and as a whole. So that is exactly what we have here now. This is so much difference. It's not only mouthfeel, of course, but mouthfeel is super super important.
Yeah, and the all the flavors are more intense on the export, and that's with the mouthfeel, but that's what the alcohol also does.
It's more intense, it's alcohol, and I wonder if they state all the ingredients. Barley, maize flour, so that's like corn.
It would surprise me if there was corn in it.
Yeah, me too. I don't think so.
This is not with corn.
Dit blikje heeft een inhoud van 53 centiliter. Met een vloeistof inhoud van 50 centiliter. Doesn't that say this in English? No. Doesn't say.
But, after all... the comparing is cool to do, but Roger said the expert one would be very different.
Well, that's totally true.
That's true. But I like them both.
I mean, as said, it is more or less in the same family because it's what's similar. It's that the finish in both is, of course, it's more sweet, but there's this dryness in it.
Mm-hmm.
And the expert one has it as well.
Yeah, well, and I think when you drink the Guinness more often, I think that you can taste the signature of a Guinness. You can taste it in it, but
yeah, and I don't drink it that often. It might be that when you have a Guinness more often, that you recognize the the soul of Guinness.
Yeah.
Do you think it will blend?
Oh, I really don't know.
It's not blend. Best, yeah, it blends, but it's not like then you have best of both worlds.
No.
Then it has more or less the lesser parts of both.
So my advice to our viewers,
do not blend. That's one.
Do not blend. When you got the opportunity to get the expert version from Uganda, or I saw on tap that there are more countries.
The Wall of Africa, the brewery, but also in Asia, everywhere around the world.
When you get an expert version and just this version, drink them both. First this one, then this one. Definitely. And you got a great beer experience. So we got a great beer experience thanks to Roger and Lieke.
You did know that there's an export version from Belgium as well, which is 7.5%. That's also
7.5.
Yeah, 7.5. It's like 1% more. It's like going up to 11. But
yeah,
that's also interesting beer. That's I think that next time. There will be a time that we'll try that one as well.
Yeah, I think so. But that for this time, we're gonna.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks very much. We're gonna drink this, enjoy them, and till next time. And maybe it will be in English, or maybe not.